Okay, well, this is the 25th of June, 2023. It's about 1:30 p.m. UK time in the afternoon. And this is for the astrologically minded. It's for those who are you who are already astrologically aware and understand the basics of astrology, because it just is. A few nights ago, I was teaching the third module of my beginner's course, and I was talking about how the sun in the sky was square Neptune. Still is, it's fading away now. And I was saying that with that sun square Neptune, first of all, it relates to a lot of maritime and oceanographic affairs, such as that massive trawl, that massive boat sinking in the Greek sea with all those hundreds of migrants being drowned, and the submarine explosion on the Titanic. And I was also saying that with the sun square Neptune, that all of these affairs, whilst tragic in themselves, were obscuring something bigger that was going on in the background that we weren't aware of at the time. And that was Thursday evening, UK time, my time. Now, in the last few days, there's been some very big developments in Russia. And I just thought to myself, well, OK, let's look at Putin's chart. I've been shying away from doing videos because every time I do, I get threats of being taken down and copyright notices, and it's all spam, but it's just discouraging. But this is too big to ignore. So I'm looking at the horoscope of Vladimir Putin, and I'm going to do my best to be astrologically objective. Vladimir Putin was born on the 7th of October, 1952, at 9:30 a.m.-ish. in Petrograd, in Russia, which makes him Libra, 12th house Libra, with unaspected moon in Gemini, unaspected moon, and Scorpio rising. The most notable thing about his chart is he has a less, 1.5 degree, that's pretty strong, conjunction of Pluto, which rules Scorpio, to the midheaven in Leo. So, I thought to myself, if I'm going to do this to the best of my abilities, let's do what I do for clients and let's have a thorough look at all the different factors going on in his chart. So the first thing I always do is I look at the progressed horoscope, because that gives me an indication where the client is internally, nothing to do with events in the outside world. And as soon as I put up Vladimir Putin's progressed horoscope, I went, oh, right. In his progress chart, as I speak, the progress sun is just about to move into 25 degrees of Sagittarius, and the progress moon is shortly, within a week and a half, going to move into 24 degrees of Sagittarius. The progress sun moves 1 degree a year. The progress moon moves about 1 degree a month. So what this tells me is that in about 30 to 40 days from now, in his progressed horoscope, there will be a progressed new moon. This happens once every 30 years. Another way of looking at exactly the same thing is to say that 70 and a half days after he was born, relating to 70 and a half years of life, there was a new moon in the sky. It's taking place at 25 degrees of Sagittarius, which is sextiling his Mercury, trining his Pluto, trining his progressed Pluto. It looks nice. And coming up to conjunct his Mars. The progressed moon will pass on top of his Mars in less than about 7 to 8 weeks' time. Straight away, I thought, well, that's actually not too bad. A new moon, a fresh start, a new beginning. But I thought, what else is going on? Where's Pluto? As we speak, Pluto is not touching Vladimir Putin's chart. Next year, it will begin a 2-year-long trine to his moon, but his moon's in Gemini and it's unaspected, which makes it a bit wild and a bit random. And with the moon in Gemini, which is not my favourite position, it can make it a bit frenetic at the mental level. Because moon in Gemini people, they always... It's never enough for them to say, I feel. It's always, but why do I feel? I've got to explain it. Also next year, Pluto begins a two-year-long trine to Vladimir Putin's ascendant in Scorpio, ruled by Pluto. So far, so good, you think? Neptune in the sky is two-thirds of the way through a long-term square to Vladimir Putin's Mars. Mars rules Aries, which in Putin's chart is the start of the sixth house. Lifestyle management, health, hygiene, diet, nutrition, exercise. With Neptune squaring his Mars, and I know this because I've been through this one, it takes it out of you for a couple of years. It brings an element of physical fatigue, tiredness, weariness, lack of direction. It can bring a sense of dissolving, of your energy slipping through your fingers like sand and water. And it does suggest to me that he is moderately, mildly worried about not only his health, but his lifestyle, his energy levels. And when I deal with clients with this, I say, look, there's nothing you can do to fight this. You've just got to give in to the fatigue. If you're normally running at 95 to 98% batteries full, then over the coming year and a half, 2 years, you're only going to be running at 80, 85%. And that's where he is now. This will clear by February, March of next year. But here's the crunch point, folks. Uranus in the sky is now at 21 degrees of Taurus, squaring Putin's midheaven, squaring Putin's Pluto. This is going to stick around until March of next year. Uranus is the change bringer. Squaring the midheaven is going to bring major change, probably at a challenging level in terms of not only things around job, work, career, goals and ambition, but public image, profile, status, visibility, the way you market, promote, advertise, sell, project yourself. And his public image has taken a real battering in the last 36 hours. Uranus will square his Pluto, which is generational. It's going to happen to everybody born the same year as him, except that Pluto rules his ascendant. So it's more significant for him than for most other people. So if Uranus squaring his Pluto, there are going to be changes in his personal life. Uranus is also conjuncting his Jupiter, starting around early April 2023, running through to early mid-February 24. Jupiter rules his second house, of where Sagittarius is, of finances, resources, assets, materials, money. So his financial situation, personal finances, are going to be taking, going through a period of change. But let's just get a couple of other minor things out the way. Jupiter is opposite his Venus now and for the next 8 months. Big deal. It rules his seventh house of relationships. He's not going to have as many friends as he would like. Okay. And Saturn in the sky is trining his ascendant and squaring his moon from now through to the early new year. But this is no big deal, particularly with the moon, because the moon is unaspected. But there are two absolute crunch points here that need to be taken into account. Firstly, the position at this moment, right now, in the sky of Mars. As I speak, Mars is at the end of 20 degrees of Leo. It will pass on Putin's midheaven tomorrow. It will square Uranus in the sky tomorrow. It will pass on top of Putin's Pluto in the next 48 to 72 hours. This is a massive time. If I were dealing with him as a client, I'd be saying, well, look, you're going to get your anger buttons pushed. There's a risk of tantrums, temper, volatility, therefore clumsiness, impatience, accident proneness, rash, volatile behaviour. And if he were a client, I'd be saying, well, look, for the next 48, 72 hours, count to 10. Because he's a global leader, his position is slightly different. And I do suspect that in this next 72 hours, he is likely to be feeling much more irate, unpredictable, and volatile than normal. The second trigger point is in April next year. And you will hear me talk a lot about this over the coming months. At the end of April next year, Jupiter and Uranus will come together at 22 degrees of Taurus, very close to his Jupiter, square his midheaven, square his Pluto. And any actions taken in the next 72 hours will have a long-term repercussion at the end of April next year. So one way of saying this is that if Putin throws his toys out the pram in the next few days and does something volatile, invasive, impulsive, angry and confrontational, then it's really going to come back and bite him at the end of April next year. Alternatively, if he uses this time to plant a lot of seeds for the future and throws a lot of fishing lines into the future, then he will reap the rewards of this in April of next year. But the fact that there is a progressed new moon in his horoscope right now, and both Mars and Uranus squaring each other are hitting his Pluto and midheaven in an extremely challenging way over the next 72 hours, gives me cause for concern. And I would be saying to him, you're at your most volatile that you've been for many, many, many years. And it's going to be very interesting from an astrological perspective to see what develops. I know that in the last 12 to 15 hours, there's been a de-escalation of events, and I hope that continues, obviously. But we shall see. We shall see. But one way or another, it does seem as if the global politic is changing now. And if one domino topples, how far can the rest be behind? We live in interesting times. Catch you later, world. Bye now.